There are hundreds of writers' centers around the country, but the Cape Cod Writers' Center is unique. Why do I say that? Well, we happen to be on the verge of our 60th anniversary. People go to writers' conferences for lots of reasons. Of course, the most important is to hear from famous or prominent writer instructors who can talk about and teach you all kinds of things about writer's craft and history of it and promotion and all of that. Very important for us to hear that, since a lot of us begin writing by ourselves. That's another reason to go to a writer's conference, because writing is a solitary endeavor, and it's really important to be with other people and have feedback. And of course, the third one related to that is networking. And when you do network with other writers, you don't feel so alone, and often you pick up new tips and new information. So with that said, I have to tell you why the Cape Cod Writers' Center 60th conference is unique. We are one of the oldest in the country. We began in 1963 when a group of writers called the 12 o'clock scholars, they were dreaming about having a summer conference with some of the famous authors who came to the Cape. And in August of that year, it became a reality. And the first person they had as a speaker was Kurt Vonnegut. This was actually, he was already famous, but he became much more so when he wrote Slaughterhouse-Five several years later. Anyway, the conference was a hit from the start, and it was held at a charming place called the Craigville Conference Center, which was a sort of a gingerbread summer community on a bluff over the Craigville beach. By the middle 1970s, the founder, Marion Vollemer, had incorporated it into the Cape Cod Writers' Center Conference, Inc. And of course, by then, there were other related activities, many of which are still going on today. For instance, there is a Books in the World television cable TV program. It's actually the oldest in the country. It's an author interview program. There was a Young Writers program. We still have that for teenagers. There were public readings that we did. There were seminars. We still have the seminars that are called Pathways to Publication. That said, let's talk about today. I just have to tell you that over the years, Mrs. Vollemer, the founder, had an incredible group of prominent authors who appeared besides Kurt Vonnegut. Among them, I'm just going to name a few. There was Edward Gorey, Don Ellis, Mary Higgins Clark, Marge Piercy, Dennis Lehane, and of course, more recently, we've had others such as Lisa Genova, Andre Dubu, Margaret Mega Wallitzer, Colin McCann, Malachi McCourt, William Martin, and B.A. Shapiro. So this gives you a flavor for what we're offering this year. We have an outstanding group of faculty. We have Verlin Klinkenborg, who was on the editorial board of the New York Times, who's our keynote speaker. We have classes in craft, you know, fiction, nonfiction, screenwriting, poetry, memoir, promotion, publicity. All of that is offered if you come to the conference. So yeah, and the dates are August 3 through 6. We used to be at the Craigville Conference Center, but in 2013, we moved to a great hotel in Hyannis, the Resort and Conference Center at Hyannis. There's air conditioning, easy access for parking, easy access for internet. Of course, there's also some swimming pools. We're downtown in Hyannis. We're right near the ferries and all of that to go to the islands and the beaches. So yeah, we hope you come. Should be a great conference.
So to understand what the Cape Cod Writers' Center means to me and what the conference has meant to me, I got to give you a little background here. I started writing when I was 16 years old. And wrote into my late 20s, wallpapering my wall with 25 to 50 rejection letters. And then I started raising a family and started getting involved in a career. Fast forward 30 years, and I now had the time, my kids were grown, and I decided to start writing again. Interestingly enough, I hadn't met another writer in 30 years since I was in college. Then I discovered the Cape Cod Writers' Center. I went to my first conference, and it was like, wow, there's 150 people here who all have the same dream. Some of them are poets, some of them are memoirists, nonfiction, fiction. Very few had been published, but some. And I was kind of a 60-year-old wide-eyed kid. I got to submit my first 5 pages to an agent who told me, thanks, but no thanks, but keep trying because you have some talent. And I met a bunch of fellow writers. And the benefit of the conference and subsequent meetings with the Writers' Center could be categorized as the workshops, the instructors, the instruction how to write, how to market your book, how to get published, plus the general hope of someday getting published. But far and away, the single biggest benefit was the camaraderie and moral support of the fellow writers. I didn't know about writers' groups. And I discovered at the conference a writers' group that met in a little old colonial church in Falmouth. And I joined it. We called ourselves the Steeple Scholars. There were six of us to start. And at the time I joined, none of us had been published. And one of the greatest obstacles of writing, I think, is the belief that you can be published. And lo and behold, one after another, several of us got published. And that group, what used to be the Steeple Scholars, has now published over 20 books. And here I am, 6 books published, and I'm working on my 7th novel. So it was, I have to honestly say, I'm not sure I would have been able to break through that mental, emotional barrier without the support of the Writers' Center.
Well, I go way back in the life of the Cape Cod Writers' Center, all the way back to Books in the World with the immortal Marion Villemere, probably with my first book, which was Back Bay. And every book since, I have come to the Cape Cod Writers' Center and appeared on Books and the World. And I have had the opportunity to speak to the audience at the Cape Cod Writers' Center as a keynote speaker once, and missed once also. That was in 1991, when I was all set to be the keynote speaker after Cape Cod. My 4th novel came out and was a New York Times bestseller, and everybody was reading it. And I traveled home from a trip to the West to make sure that I would be there on Cape Cod for that particular special event, because it meant a lot to me to speak to that group on that wonderful old campus where you used to be down there in Hyannis. And then Hurricane Bob came along and knocked out all the power on Cape Cod. And I never got to give that speech at the Cape Cod Writers' Center. However, there have been many pleasant interactions with that group. And I say that because as a writer, no matter where you are on the spectrum of professional achievement or success or whatever you want to call it, every writer likes to be in a place where they know that they are among people who respect what it is that they do, who respect the art of storytelling, the art of research, whether it's fiction or nonfiction, and who hold every writer up to a certain level of high standard that is simply a motivation for every writer to keep writing and to keep getting better. And that's what I have always sensed when I've been in the presence of people from the Cape Cod Writers' Center. That's why I think it's a fantastic place and why I look forward to another 60 years of success with the Cape Cod Writers' Center. And another keynote speech, perhaps, some summer in the near future.